Torr Bay, the chosen arena for the yachtsmen of the Olympic regatta. There are five classes competing in the regatta: the International 6-meter, the Dragon, the Star, the Swallow, and the Firefly. Every class races on each day of the regatta. The final awards are based on the total number of points gained by each competing country. Here's part of a typical contest in the 6-meter class, with the leading crew hoisting the spinnaker as the wind freshens. Now the Star class. Chief honours for the day and for the regatta went to the USA. Whose elements of comradeship, danger, and achievement make it a very notable part of any Olympiad.
In the first leg of the 2,000 meters tandem final. Great Britain versus Italy. And the British pair, Reg Harris and Alan Bannister, are well in the lead as they reach the peak of the race. But now the Italians are dangerously close. Britain crams on the pace, but the Italians hang on grimly, and now they make a determined sprint. But Harris and Bannister prove equal to the challenge. Great Britain wins the race, but not the title. The Italians gaining the championship by 2 victories to 1. Windsor and His Royal Highness the Duke of Edinburgh arrives to greet the competitors at the start of the cycle road race of 120 miles. 96 riders from 29 countries, and they're all set as the Duke prepares to fire the starting pistol. massive field, all hoping to win Olympic honors. But more than 40 of them are doomed to drop out before the end of the long grind. In the early stages, turns are something of a nightmare. One fall in a field of this size is generally followed by others. Around the course, they keep a sharp lookout for the leaders. And here they come, Johansson of Sweden and the Dutch champions, Voorting and Vanhoff. Down to another landmark of the course, Blacknest Gate. They take it in their stride, but there's plenty of trouble not far ahead. And here it comes, a collision which has plenty of repercussions. Too bad that it happened just where it did, but even the arrival of the official car doesn't stem the tide of some perfectly natural feelings. A story that needs no words. On they go, but by this time the course is really taking its toll. Andersen of Denmark has tire trouble, and for the moment he's out of the running. Vanhoff of Holland deals with his share of the bad luck. The leaders push on, but before long Vanhoff has fixed that tire and is ready for the next round. Other casualties come thick and fast, all working furiously to get back into the race. One by one they're feeling the pace, but they all battle on gamely, determined to finish the course. The service pits are kept busy supplying spares and tires, not forgetting the refreshments picked up by the competitors as they flash by. Round they come again, and who's in front now? It's a British rider, G.W. Thomas, and with him Delatour of Belgium, Voorting of Holland, Huben of Australia, and Maitland, also of Great Britain. Thomas still leads, going strongly as they reach the last few miles. Another downhill stretch, and here's a newcomer in the lead. It's José Bayert of France. Maitland of Britain is just behind. Thomas has dropped back. Now the order's changed again, and Thomas of Britain is back in the lead. Bayert lies second, and it's a duel all the way between Britain and France. Less than a mile to go, and Bayert really puts on the pressure, and he's all on his own. A brilliant sprint gives the Frenchman an unbeatable lead, and he's coming home to a great win. José Bayert had completed a magnificent piece of riding, 120 miles in just over 5 hours, 18 minutes.
The River Thames at Henley, the famous battleground of so many generations of British oarsmen, and now the picturesque setting for the international rowing events of the 14th Olympiad. For 3 days, the heats and semifinals were fought out, and now in the final of the eight, it's a three-cornered fight between Great Britain, Norway, and the United States of America. Norway on the far side, USA in the center, and Great Britain nearest the camera. From a good start, the British crew go into the lead. But already the machine-like precision of the Californian crew begins to tell. At the 1,000-meter mark, the Americans are ahead. Britain makes a stern bid to draw level, but it's too late. The US crew is 2.5 lengths ahead, coming home with that swinging stroke of theirs to a resounding victory. Another final, the Coxed Fours. Three countries represented, the USA, Switzerland and Denmark, in one of the closest races of the whole regatta. Once again, the well-drilled Americans are in the lead. Close behind, the pursuing Swiss are cramming on the pace. So are the Danes. But it's the Americans' race from now on, and there they go, a victorious crew indeed. To make the occasion complete, the American custom of ducking the cocks is not forgotten. The coxless pairs and left to right, Great Britain, Switzerland, Italy. They're away and the British pair, Laurie and Wilson, are watched by eager eyes as Switzerland take an early lead of half a length. At 1,000 meters, Laurie and Wilson are ahead, a perfectly matched pair in the race of their lives. Switzerland make a strong challenge, but the British pair, rowing as well as ever, hold it off. A final spurt, and Laurie and Wilson come up to the finishing line with the style of true champions. So Britain scored one of her two victories in the Olympic regatta at Henley.
Back at Wembley Stadium, the equestrian events reached their climax with the Prix des Nations, rightly celebrated as the world's greatest show jumping test for man and horse. 44 riders, the cream of 15 nations, and a 1,000-meter course with 16 obstacles, each with its own peculiar difficulties. An early competitor clips one of the parallel bars, and down it goes. Major Anjou of Turkey has trouble at the double, as many of them did. Here's a sound jump, but later progress is not quite so good. Each obstacle knocked down means four faults against the rider. One of the French team, Captain Maupeou d'Ablège. A good jump, and now for the next. No, a bad fall, and that led to his elimination. Colonel Frierson of the United States was equally unlucky, to say nothing of a quick getaway by his horse. Danger ahead for Captain Acton of Denmark. Major Martins of Portugal and a refusal at the logs, the very first jump. A penalty of 3 points, but the second attempt is faultless. Count Bettoni of Italy. Here's Lieutenant Colonel Nicholl of Great Britain on Kilgeddy. Good going, Great Britain. Russell of the USA, yes, nicely over the parallel bars, but at the rustic gates. What a refusal. The triple bars and the sleepers seem to present the least difficulty. This competitor clears the stile nicely, too. Commandant Cruz of Spain takes the jumps at a cracking pace. Better still, Captain Ruben Urizar of Mexico. Only 8 faults, and that means he's tying for the lead. Now comes Mariles Cortez, also of Mexico, who provides the real drama. With very nearly an immaculate performance, Mariles Cortez in the last ride of the day snatches the individual honors. Also achieves the best team placing, with Spain second and Great Britain third in the Prix des Nations.